olfactory nerves, which are the smell nerves. And these olfactory nerves carry this nanoaluminum directly to the part of the brain that's first affected in Alzheimer's disease and most severely affected in Alzheimer's disease. And that's the entorhinal cortex and the hippocampus. When you look at Alzheimer's patients and measure aluminum levels, you see the highest level at that entry point from the olfactory nerve into the entorhinal cortex. So we have good evidence that aluminum is entering the nose and entering the part of the brain that's affected in Alzheimer's, causing abnormalities in memory and learning and attention and concentration. When you do this experimentally, you can trace this with a radioactive tracer and watch the nanoaluminum pass along that nerve into the brain, and then it's distributed throughout the brain. You keep doing that day after day, the levels get pretty high. Now, my concern with the geoengineering was the word I got, and when I started looking it up, and one of the conferences in which their speaker was talking about it, they talked about using nanoaluminum, and the reason they were using it, they say, well, it stays suspended in the atmosphere longer because the particle's so small, and it acts like a cloud to reflect the heat supposedly back out into outer space. Well, the problem is it slowly descends down to the earth, enters the lakes and streams, plants take it up. So then the aluminum content of the plants we eat is much higher, the water we drink is much higher, and we breathe it. The filters in house filtering systems not small enough to filter it out, so gradually nanoaluminum content inside your house elevates. And what we know is that nanoaluminum is infinitely more inflammatory than normal size aluminum. So it's more toxic to the brain once it gets in. And it can penetrate all parts of the cell. It easily passes through the membranes and blood-brain barrier, etc. So knowing all of this, I was just astounded that they were spraying hundreds and thousands of tons of nanoaluminum all over the world, particularly the United States. And I, you know, did a little research and looked in my own case in my skies, and I see these tight patterns, and it's obvious a pattern. It's not contrails. The whole thing of contrails is nonsense. You'd watch a plane fly, and it turns on this cloud and of material coming out of the back of it, and it stops, and there's a break, and then it starts back up. Well, I knew the jet's not cutting his engine off.
Right.
So, you know, you have a 747 or a 767 or something. We know it's not turning its engine on and off, and we know that it's not flying in a checkered pattern. And then pretty soon, for instance, we've noticed lately there's been none of the chemtrails or very few of them. Well, did the flight stop over the United States for the last month? Well, no.
Yeah.
Usually have about the same number of flights every day, every week, every month. So those chemtrails should be the same, but they don't. They vary considerably. You'll see periods in which there's very dense trails, chemtrails in the sky, and periods where there's hardly any, but there's just as many flights.
But there's many skeptics out there that will say, you know, I mean, for me, when I start talking about geoengineering, I just kind of watch people's eyes glaze over and they're going, right. And, you know, I think that's very much by design. There's a lot of people out there that it's their job to debunk this information.
Well, one of the greatest successes they had is to create the idea that anything that smacks of a conspiracy theory is loony.
Right.
Which gives great cover for people who are conspiring things. Now, there's thousands of studies on the toxicity of aluminum. You don't need to do studies. So this is from people who are actually in governmental conferences on geoengineering. That takes it out of the conspiracy realm. This is out of the horse's mouth. We know that the conferences on global warming all include talks and discussions of geoengineering. So, you know, it's like a detective story. You put all the data together, that's hard facts and their own facts, and pretty soon it becomes undeniable. And you ask the people who refute you and roll their eyes, well, how do you explain it? Well, I don't know. You know, well, don't you think it behooved you to find out?
Well, I've had
You
people
know?
on the show like Rosalind Peterson and Dane Wigington, and their evidence is indisputable. And Dane Wigington challenges anyone. Actually, he wanted me to do a show if I could find someone that would challenge him. And I haven't been able to find anybody.
Well, they can't, because if you look at some of the things that's been done, for instance, biologists have gone into some of these areas where there's extensive spraying, and they measured the aluminum level before the spraying started in the local lakes and streams and snow, and found out that after the spraying, the levels of aluminum went up astronomically, thousandfold increases. When they measured in the plants and trees, massive increases in the aluminum. So your question to the eye roller is, well, where do you think this aluminum came from? I don't know. Well, it's time to find out. You can't just roll your eyes and scoff. If you can't explain how a lake within a year or months can increase its aluminum level to that degree, then I think somebody needs to start paying attention. We're already seeing a dramatic increase in degenerative brain disorders like Alzheimer's and Parkinson's. I predict if they're really doing this, if they're spraying the atmosphere with nanoaluminum all the time, there's going to be a dramatic increase in Alzheimer's and Parkinson's, as well as a number of neurologic disorders.
Well, what is there anything we can do to counter the effects of all this aluminum?
Yeah, a number of supplements have been shown to bind and neutralize aluminum toxicity. For instance, curcumin, which is a flavonoid extract of the spice turmeric. Quercetin helps neutralize it.
Quercetin. I have
Saffron.
taken quercetin for allergies. Is if we're
Yeah, I
talking
mean,
about the
it's.
same.